Remember prepare? So do I. But prepare did not prepare us for COVID-19, for the shutdown of our schools, for the postponement of our grad activities. Rest assured though, this is just a blip. Sometimes things don't go the way we plan. And so we adapt, we grow, we learn, we carry on. Congratulations, class of 2020. You are living history. Now go and tell your story.
Hello, grads. I want to say two things. Number one, I miss you guys. And number two, congratulations on this incredible moment in your lives. I hope to see you soon. Take care.
If you can graduate during COVID-19 remote learning, you can do anything. You are resilient and you can do hard things. The future holds a lot of exciting prospects for you.
Dream big and go on to great, great things. Please keep in touch. Don't be strangers. Come and visit.
I'm going to be like a decimal and get to the point. Congratulations. Today we celebrate you. We celebrate your accomplishments, your goals, and your hard work. To sum it up, congratulations, graduates. And in terms of calculus, know your limits. Derive within it.
Dance like no one's watching.
Dedicate that dance to you because you deserve to be celebrated. You look amazing today. You look beautiful in your gowns and so handsome in your tuxedos. I hope you're having a great celebration with your family.
Remember when your parents and grandparents used to say they used to walk to school uphill both ways? Well, you get to tell your kids or grandkids that you actually had to stay at home for school. Anyways, congratulations, you earned it. Cheerio for now.
Be proud of yourself and all of your accomplishments. Know that we as teachers are proud of you and we will continue to do so. We're always there on the sidelines, ready to cheer you on.
So you're beautiful in your own crazy. And what I realize about you and what I love about your class is that you are beautiful, crazy.
I am really sorry for everything that went down and the fact that you're probably watching this from your home right now. But it's just one more thing that adds to your character. Just one more thing that you guys have gotten through and persevered through, and we'll just keep carrying on. Keep being awesome, keep doing the great things that you guys are known to do.
We all miss you and wish we could be together today. Congratulations, I wish you the very best and I hope I get to see you very soon.
Every time that I was teaching you, I don't even know if you knew it, but you were teaching me.
Some of the best friends you never will meet, you haven't met yet. You know, you have great friends, but there's new things waiting for you. Her and I met each other in the first year of university, and it turned out pretty great, so.
Hey, grad class of 2020, congratulations on graduating. Remember in life, you always gotta shoot your shot.
You're a graduate. Classy, aged, passionate. Clever, mature, confident. Moving out, high school, you're done with it.
You're not slacking.
Never slacking, you're a graduate.
Hey grads, as you embark on this next big step in your life, remember to continue seeking out new opportunities when they arise. Don't be afraid to try new things, explore your passions, reflect often, and don't forget to have fun.
So take care. We miss you right now, but we know that you're going to go out there and do great things, and we look forward to seeing you again.
Whatever you are doing, in the words of Rod Stewart, who is playing in the background, may sunshine and happiness surround you when you're far from home. Be courageous and be brave. And in my heart, you'll always stay forever young. Congratulations.
I wish you guys all the best, and I hope that every day you're able to find a little bit of time to enjoy this beautiful earth, get out and experience nature, recharge your batteries, and take some risks and have fun in life. Good luck.
To my own graduate, Alexi, it's been my absolute joy to go to school with you for the past 4 years. And next year I'm gonna miss looking out my office door and seeing you and your friends at the table area after band.
Some of your biggest obstacles in life are created by you. I can't. I don't know how. I'll do it later. I'm not good enough. I'm not smart enough. Do your best not to get in your own way. Work hard. Surround yourself with people who believe in you. And prove yourself wrong.
I am so very proud of you. You have gotten to this point, and you deserve a long distance high five.
Congratulations, class of 2020. I'm sure this is only the beginning of the many great things you're going to accomplish. Don't forget to keep me posted. Take care.
It's me, Mr. Falkenberg. Yeah, the social studies teacher at the Bad Puns. And like Neil Armstrong said, remember, high school is just like one small step in your life. But I hope it's a step that was filled with very fond memories of friends, classmates, full of precious memories of things that you experienced and you learned, things that are more precious than all the gold and diamonds in the world.
Try new things. Do things that scare you. Be willing to fail. I'm going to keep the hoop on the wall for when you come back and you can play.
In Science 9, we learned to code. We went on a field trip to the Calgary Zoo. We made models of the cell, did my obstacle course, wrote diplomas until they were canceled. You've participated in clubs and represented our school. My own kids have seen your determination and your kindness. You showed them resilience on the field and off the field.
Way to go, Bearcats!
I wish you all the best. To the 15 graduating players from our football program, I'd like to give a special shout out for all they've done in our building for the last 4 years and within our team. And as always, don't be strangers. See you around sometime. Thanks.
I want to thank you for the times that I was able to spend with you in the fishbowl, in your classes, the times that I was able to coach you on the improv team or attend your games or meetings or performances. You guys have been amazing. And the main thing that I remember about you, and I think is your characteristic, is you are very determined. You know what it is that you want, and you persist until you get it.
Years down the road, you are going to remember your time at Hunting Hills with Miss Soltis and I, and we definitely want those memories to be positive.
You're number one. You're number one.
In 20 years, you'll look back on 2020 with your 2020 vision
and realize how impactful an experience it has been,
how much it has defined your outlook and your identity.
And what a story.
Yeah, don't let the fears in your mind get in the way of the dreams in your heart.
Take a couple of your goals, and instead of just thinking about them now and then, put them on an index card. You stick this index card one place that you're stuck every day, and on that mirror where you're brushing your teeth for 4 or 5 minutes every day, and think about.
Good luck in your future. Please try to come back and visit in the fall, if we're allowed to visit in the fall, and tell me how your time was and how your future looks. Good luck on everything in your future.
Treasure your accomplishments, dream big, and take risks. Inspire others, live your best life filled with adventures, laughter, and love.
Personally, I have so many funny memories of you guys, and they often bring a smile to my face. You are a fantastic group of humans, and I feel privileged to have gotten to know so many of you. I'm so proud of you all. Now, in the face of adversity, I want you to continue on, finish strong, and pursue your goals and dreams.
I also want to say congratulations to the rugby players that were coming out to rugby. 31 that are seasoned rugby players. We would have knocked it out of the park this year.
You started way down here.
And you made Hunting Hills your home. Home is not a place, it's a feeling.
Once you arrived, you chose hope, and you realized anything is possible.
You realized great satisfaction comes from sharing with others.
You let your imagination take flight and soar.
As you move forward to the next step in your life, take with you these words of wisdom.
Life is like a boomerang. The more energy you give out, the more you get back.
Life is a balance of holding on and letting go.
Greatest wealth is your health.
Success is not final. Failure is not fatal. It's the courage and honor to continue that counts.
And remember, wherever you go, follow your heart. And always follow the power of age.
Congratulations to the graduating class of 2020.
One, two.
It's times like these, time and time again.
Let's go. It's times like these that we activate. Do something to improve, don't procrastinate. I've been cooking out, make a wicked pasta plate. Stream games at 11, but I clap at 8. And I'll jiggle FaceTime if you tempt me. Time to pay back all the health docs left me. And for me, West 10's elementary. But right now, I wanna see Labra go empty, you get me?
We'll make it better together, we'll make a better life. Because the pressure is ever upon us every night. And every day, so we pray.
Follows you back home. Mm-hmm.
Oh, and the streetlights shining, and while that light burns your fingers.
It's times like these you learn to live again. It's times like these.
I would have to say my favorite high school memory was getting involved in sports.
I'd like to thank my friends for helping me procrastinate on everything that I'm supposed to be doing for my homework and my classes, and helping me create all these memories.
My favorite class would have to be AP Lit, because A, it was super fun to get sidetracked from our work, B, everyone in that class is super supportive, and C, Metzner gives the best inspirational speeches.
My favorite high school memory would be playing in the jazz band, because it gave me a sense of community. It felt like I belonged in a group that was bigger than my friend group.
I would like to thank my parents for helping me graduate, for believing in me when I didn't believe in myself, for supporting me, for always being there for me, and for helping me get over every single obstacle that was ever thrown in my way.
We'd like to thank Mr. Sterling for never having a shortage of gum or chocolate in his room for us to eat, as well as putting up with some of us since grade 7 and always knowing how to make our day better.
We'd also like to thank Ms. Harvey for helping us get through math for once in our life.
And actually wanting to go to class.
We'd also like to thank Jen and Ms. Bunt
for always supporting us and wanting the best for us.
So I would like to thank Mrs. Heiskanen, aka my mom, for being a wonderful grade 9 science teacher, always supporting me and pushing me to do my best. Thanks, Mom.
My favorite memory was BikeCon 2019 because it was a great experience.
I'd like to thank Mr. Winneke for guiding me through all of high school and making sure I get enough credits to graduate.
Thank you. would like to thank my friends and family for helping me graduate, as well as Ms. Brown, Mr. McKay, Ms. Metzner, and Mr. Fredrickson.
I'd like to thank Roscoe, Sorensen, Cosby, and Jennifer Boiteau for helping me graduate. If it wasn't for them always pushing me, I wouldn't have made it.
My favorite classes were all of my med studies and sports med classes. We got to do a lot of fun projects and meet a lot of cool people.
To thank Roscoe, Jennifer, Sorensen, and Cosby for helping me graduate. I wouldn't have been able to do it without them. They pushed me when I didn't want to do it, and they always believed in me when I didn't believe in myself.
Big family, and everyone worked together to work to a common goal, and it was just a great time.
These past 4 years has been so much fun being in improv. I've loved every second of it.
Favorite class would be Math 30 because, well, I'm good at it. I had quite a few friends in it. My teacher was really good. I enjoyed the class.
Favorite high school memory was walking into Hunting for the first time and seeing where I would be for the next 4 years and looking at all the possibilities to see where I could go.